Stormy Bracket!
Judas and the Black Messiah is currently in theaters as well as streaming on HBO Max. It is a film that was originally supposed to come out last year, but unfortunately with the pandemic and everything, it got pushed back to this year. And I guess it's technically considered a 2021 film. And right off the bat, I have to say, I was very much so excited for this movie. The trailer looked very much so engaging. And honestly, I didn't really know too much about this part of history in America. So I was very curious to see this film. And also, I'm a huge fan of Daniel Kaluuya, as well as Lakeith Stanfield and Jesse Plemons. These are three actors that are at the top of their field in terms of, you know, actors. And it's really good to see them in these kind of roles because I think that these performances are very nuanced. I think that this is a film that is timely, obviously. It's almost like Black Klansman meets The Irishman, I think is the best way of putting this movie. And I don't think it's nearly as good as either of those two movies, but I definitely think that this is a film that is important to watch at least once. And the reason why I say that is because, like I said, I feel like not many people know too much about this particular event that occurred, as well as, you know, the documentary that was focused on this too. Like when the end credits rolled and I realized what happened in terms of the real life individual after the interview, I was like, oh, wow. So it's definitely a film I think is worth watching for that alone. Now, the other thing I wanted to say is that it's pretty impressive because this is the first time director and the directing is really strong. There's a sense of dread in terms of like what's going to happen next because you feel like you're off kilter a lot of times with the way it's shot and everything and the usage of close-ups. But more importantly, there's just energy. There's just energy to the mundane tasks that are at hand. And there's this feeling of anything can happen. I think that's something that is really intriguing. And a lot of times I criticize films that are based on true stories because a lot of times they feel predictable and everything. But this felt refreshing despite obviously being a cluster of like, oh, you've seen some of these tropes in other movies, but the way it's done and presented, it's really good. As I already mentioned, the acting is also really strong. I think the standout would have to be Daniel Kaluuya. He's great. He's great in everything, but he's a standout for me personally. I also like the cinematography, as I already mentioned, with the close-ups and everything. I think usually I'm not a huge fan of close-ups. Like, I like it when there's close-ups, but it's done very, very minuscule because then when there is a close-up shot, you're like, okay, this is important. But when a film has a lot of close-ups, I feel like a lot of times it kind of loses that reasoning as to why you would want to do a close-up, even though obviously it's different from person to person with why they want to do it. But with this film, the way they use the close-ups, as I already said, it gives that feeling of claustrophobic and just a really intense moment throughout the movie. The action scenes, there's only like two, also are really intense and honestly are really important in terms of like the story, which is also something that is important. In terms of negatives, I think the only negatives I really have is that although for the most part I really like the pacing, I do think that there are some scenes that last a little bit too long. I think that it could have been cut down a little bit, not too much. And then there are, as I already mentioned, there's certain tropes of the genre that are focused on. But I also just wish that, and this is a minor gripe, but still something I have, I wish that Lakeith Stanfield and Daniel Kaluuya, I wish their relationship was built a little bit more. So this is a film that feels a little bit too long, whilst at the same time being a little bit underwritten in terms of certain things, such as their relationship. I do kind of wish that it was built a little bit more, but that's just, again, a personal preference. Overall, it's a very important movie. It's good in terms of its filmmaking, not amazing, but still it's good. It's got timely messages, and honestly, the themes are something where it's crazy. You know, it's one of those things where it's like, this was 60 years ago when it happened, and now more than ever, it's relevant. And it's kind of scary, but, you know, it's a shame. But nonetheless, I still would highly recommend you check out Judas and the Black Messiah because it's a good film. It's important. And honestly, I could see this being a movie that's shown in school because it's important to watch. And it shows, again, as I already mentioned before several times, it showcases something that we as audiences haven't really seen before in terms of this particular event. So that's why Judas and the Black Messiah, I personally will be giving a 4 out of 5 star rating, which feels like a hot sauce rating. It's the good old Louisiana crystal part. Louisiana pure crystal hot sauce. So, yeah, that's my review, guys. I know I'm keeping it kind of brief, keeping it short, but I feel like a lot of people haven't seen this movie. Haven't really heard too much chatter other than, you know, getting nominated at the Golden Globes. But would definitely recommend you check it out. And if you have seen it, I'm all about talking about this movie down below. If you want me to further explain certain points, I'm all about that down below. And as always, guys, Thank you very much for watching. You guys are the best. And as always, don't forget the subscription, notification bell, and I'll catch you guys later.